the ODA component compliance test kits, there's two levels of validation. The level one is validating the component complies with the underlying design guidelines that apply to all components. And the level two is validating the components meet the mandatory functional capabilities from the component inventory for each specific component. There's a good analogy with Lego where there's a set of underlying design guidelines that every Lego block must meet. And then there's a variety of individual specified Lego blocks that you could build. In the CTK, we have a set of scripts, and there's a level one and a level two scripts. And for each one, there's a static, which is just looking at the design time definition, and there's a dynamic one, actually exercising, calling through the APIs, running components. And I can run these scripts using this simple command line, and it's using the same underlying technologies used in the OpenAPI CTKs. So run the level one script, you can see it's done a whole series of tests, including things like checking that the component is exposing APIs to a core function as management and security metadata. This is saying every component has to meet a minimum set of standard design guidelines. Then I have a component running in the background, and I can run some dynamic tests against this. So I run the level one dynamic tests. So this is actually calling that running component through its APIs. And again, it's testing a set of mandatory attributes that every component must have. My level two, and I've got a product catalog component, my level two test is going to then say, I'm going to test that my component meets the mandatory functionality that the component inventory says the product catalog has to have. And so you can see it's actually testing for APIs from what we call the golden component in the component inventory. And then finally, I can do my level two, which is going to dynamically test that product catalog. And this actually builds on the OpenAPI CTKs. For every OpenAPI a component is meant to have, it runs through the full suite of OpenAPI tests. And I warn you that this component, it isn't compliant. And so this test should actually show where that component is non-compliant. And what you actually get a report from the test. And the report gives you some detailed information about why this component wasn't fully compliant with the component CTK.